What's up, guys? Matt here from MyRawIntuition.com, back with another video to show you guys what I'm having for dinner tonight, as well as give you guys some ideas on how to handle salt cravings if you're somebody that deals with salt cravings. And I know a lot of people do. We kind of talked about that in the interview that I had with Lori Knight earlier today. So it made me want to just make a video here giving you guys some suggestions on how you can handle salt cravings. Now, the first little tip is if you have a dehydrator, you can chop up a few celery stalks and put them in the dehydrator for like 24 hours at 105 degrees, and then put those into a blender, a high-speed blender preferably, and then just blend it up into this fine powder, and you can use that as a replacement to just typical salt. I'm also putting in some wakame seaweed into my salad tonight. Seaweed is a good source of sodium, so that'll give it a nice salty flavor. I like to put seaweed into my salads like 3 or 4 times a week. Another thing, and this is my salad tonight. So greens themselves, eating a lot of greens helps to kind of blunt salt cravings. You get those minerals in there and that helps with the cravings. Also things like tomatoes are a good source of sodium, like celery as well. Eat a lot of celery. That's one thing that I think more people need to eat. Is celery. So you can eat celery on its own, or you can juice celery, or put it in your dressings. Just find different ways to get it into your diet. Also staying hydrated. So putting some lemon in your water is a great way to get some minerals in as well, and to stay hydrated to avoid those cravings. Now my dressing also has some dill in there. So salt is a little stimulating, and so are herbs and spices. So you can replace salt with different herbs and spices to kind of get that same effect, but you're not getting those negative effects from the salt. All right. So those are kind of my tips to give you guys for if you're dealing with salt cravings. There's several different things you can do, but that's just a few ways that you can do that. Now, if you want to hear about some of the non-food related ways you can deal with salt cravings, go over to Celine's channel. I'm going to link it down in the description box below, Celine Fruit Wanderer. She's going to make a video on this, but talking more about some of the mental or the emotional side of salt cravings. But let's get more into what I'm having tonight for dinner. All right, so like I showed you, we got the salad. I've got some romaine. I've got arugula. I've got parsley. Got these grape tomatoes. And I've also got a couple cucumbers. For my dressing, I've got a half of a lemon that's peeled. I've got some dill, one medjool date, one clove of garlic, and 1/3 cup hemp seeds. And then I'm gonna put in like a half a cup of water as well. So that's gonna make a delicious salad. Again, get as many greens in your diet as you can. That's gonna help you with cravings, and it's gonna just remineralize your body. I mean, look at how green that is. When you get green into your diet, you're clean on the inside. So I hope that is helpful for you guys. I hope you have a great night, and I'll catch you next time. Always follow your raw intuition.